Hello, Trendy Day reporting in.
Hey everybody, Trendy Nay reporting in with another episode of Cooking with Nay. This is one of my favorite all-time meals to make for lunch. I do this usually about once every 2 weeks or so. What I'm going to show you is how to make a tuna melt. Now, you would think that making a tuna melt is just a matter of taking some tuna fish and throwing it on some bread with some cheese and baking it, and then you're done. You're more than welcome to do that. But I have a special way of making my tuna melts, and that's what I'd like to share with you today. I think one of the most important things about a tuna melt, aside from, of course, what kind of a bread you're going to use, I love a bagel, a toasted bagel for my tuna melt, is the type of tuna fish that you're going to use. And it's very important. One thing I've learned is to go solid white albacore tuna in water. It doesn't matter the brand. Just always make sure you get the solid white. And don't be fooled by other names. You know, they've got all kinds of chunk white, chunk light, you know, all kinds of names and stuff like that. Solid white, that gives you nice big chunks of white tuna fish and not that pink, disgusting, smushy stuff that I don't like to make my tuna melts with. Also, you can substitute mayonnaise for the Miracle Whip. I personally love Miracle Whip in my tuna melts as opposed to mayonnaise. Mustard, my secret ingredient. Vlasic pickles. Excuse me. Get yourself a dill pickle. It doesn't matter what kind. You can use one or two dill pickles, and you'll see how we use that later. I like a little Nature Seasons, and definitely very important for a Nay's tuna melt, oregano. Oregano is one of my favorite ingredients in almost all the things I make, but it's very important in this. And last but not least, peppercini and onion, and of course some Swiss cheese to melt over it all. We're going to use a toaster to make this. So you basically just need a plate, a knife, these ingredients right here, and you're ready to go. Next thing I'm going to do is chop up the onion. I'm going to cut the pickle a certain way, and I'll show you why later. And I'll get the bagel prepared. So I'll see you in a minute.
Peace.
It doesn't matter how much of these ingredients you use. A fair amount is fine. The more you put in, the chunkier your tuna will be. And I really like my tuna nice and chunky with lots of crunchy, crispy, yummy vegetables in it. So the more the better. You're not going to hurt it. But when you take the dill pickle, make sure to cut two slices like this off the pickle before you chop your pickle up. What you're going to do is you're going to take those two pickle slices and put them over the holes of the bagel so the tuna doesn't fall through. That's it. And
okay,
now we're going to chop
so
up
we've
our
got
veggies.
The onions chopped up, the dill pickle, and then the peppercini. We've got our two slices of pickle over here.
And now we've got our tuna fish out of the can. We're just going in a bowl, and we're just going to add the chopped up vegetables to the tuna fish, except for the two pickles, of course. Then we're going to add the Miracle Whip. Usually about one heaping tablespoon is enough. And then mustard, I like to just loop it on. Just throw some on, mix it in with the Miracle Whip. You don't go crazy with this stuff. But just it really helps with flavor. And then oregano and the Nature Seasons. So here, let's see if I can just take these pickle slices and set them aside. It's kind of challenging to do this all with one hand. Let me see here if I can dump the veggies in here now. Not bad, not bad. Not bad from the one-armed guy, the one-armed photographer. Okay, here we go. Now, we've got our stuff in here. I'm going to show you how much mustard I put on. Oh, don't forget to shake your mustard first, which I almost forgot to do. Shake it really good, get it all mixed up in there. And then just take your mustard and, like I said, loop it on there. I put about that much on. And then I'm going to take my Miracle Whip here. And I'm going to take a spoon here. Give me a second.
Yeah. And I'm going to take, say, about this much Miracle Whip. Throw that on top. Now, this is a large can of tuna. If you guys are wondering, I'm using a large can of tuna, not the small cans. That's why it looks like there's so much stuff in here. And then you can take your oregano. Very important if you're going to do this my way, to use oregano. So go out and get yourself some oregano if you want to taste the same flavors that I'm tasting here. Plenty of oregano in here, okay? Don't be scared of the oregano. And a little bit, don't go crazy with this stuff, a little bit of the Nature Seasons. Now, you don't have to go crazy with that either, just a dash. Now, we're going to mix this up. Now, the secret is not to smash it until it's absolutely nothing. We're going to mix it up into just to get the contents all mixed together, not really smash it up. Smash the tuna up a little bit, but you'll see when we come back what it looks like. And we're going to prepare the bagel with the two pickle slices. I'll see you in a second.
Okay, we're back. Peace. And I have I've gone ahead and mixed the tuna fish to my liking. And I wanted to tell you that it's good to have the consistency to where it will actually hold together. Basically, you want to be able to take the spoon and press against the tuna fish and have it hold its shape, okay? If it does that, then you've mixed it perfectly and it's ready to be put on the bagel, okay? Here's our bagel with our two pickles. Those are going to prevent the tuna from falling through the hole. And we've got our Swiss cheese. Now, all we have to do is spoon the tuna into a dome shape on top of the pickles, okay? And you can just, as you put the tuna on, you can press down to level it off and to give it a good base. You want a nice, good base to build on, basically. It's almost like building a little house. And a nice, good foundation will make sure that the rest is gonna hold together. And that's the trick. You know, you want these to hold together through the toasting process. You don't want them to fall apart on you. So the right amount of mayonnaise and mustard is key to ensuring that your tuna melts will come out nice and stiff the way you want it, crispy and stiff. So, you know, once again, I'm doing this with one hand holding the camera with the other. It's a little challenging, and I apologize for not being better prepared with the cameraman. But when you live alone, sometimes you've got to make do with what you've got, right, guys? It's the trendy way. So we're almost done here, actually, with building these. You basically want to put on, as you want to load on as much tuna fish on these, on your bagel or bread, whatever you're going to use, as much as you can fit on there. And also kind of take into consideration how much food you want to eat for your meal. Because the beautiful thing about what we just created is this, what I've got left over here in the bowl now. Now, this is great. This, the way this is holding up, you see the way that's holding up? It's sticking together really nice. That's just the way you want it. You want it to hold together just like that. The beautiful thing is we've got this big bowl of tuna fish now. We can take that, put it in a Tupperware, and stick it in the fridge, have it for dinner, make tuna melts again tonight or tomorrow, or just eat it just like that. I'm telling you, it's fantastic. It's very convenient. It's great for the bachelor-type life. And now we've got our tuna fish piled on here. Then you just take your Swiss cheese and put it on there like that. Now, you can pre-toast the bagels. Not necessary. You don't have to do that. But now we're just going to take them and we're going to put them on a... I've got a toaster pan here. And I'm just going to set them on the toaster pan. And put them in, and you just put them on regular. I just usually toast them, so I just put them on toast. And then my oven here has a broil option, and I can select broil and really heat up the tops and crisp up the tops. And that's what I usually do when I'm done toasting. You know, after about 5 minutes, I toast it, and then I hit broil, and I sear the cheese on top, and I make it crispy and black. We'll come back and see if I'm able to do that. I don't want to take up too much time in this video of doing stuff that's taking up too much time. So anyway, here we are in the toaster. We'll see you in a few minutes.
They're coming together quite nicely. The toasting still has a minute and a half left on it,
but I just wanted to let you all see how they're doing, give you a little progress report. Once these are melted down enough, I'm going to go ahead and hit broil to scorch the top a little bit. And I think now would be a good time to do that, actually. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm just going to hit broil. Let me stop what I'm doing and hit broil and start. And that's going to turn on the heat above that bagel and really affect that the cheese on top now rather quickly, too. I can already see it bubbling. I can actually open the door on this toaster and it'll stay on. Pretty cool toaster, actually. From Cuisine Art. Those things are looking great. All right, I'm going to cut the film here and see you guys when they're done, which would be about one more minute probably.
Okay, well, here they are coming out of the toaster here. Now, you can use an oven to do this. You can bake them at, 350 or 400 degrees, something like that. That's fine, too. But the thing is, you just don't want to overcook your bread. That's something you want to keep in mind while you're doing this. Just take it easy on the bread. Like I said, you can toast it first if that's your preference. Here, look at this. I'm using a spatula here to get these out. And they look perfect. They're, I would have scorched the tops, but they didn't seem like the cheese that I was using didn't seem to really want to burn on the top so much. So I just let it cook nice and long, and I made sure it's done. But this is going to be a delicious tuna melt meal. I'm so glad that you guys watch these videos and that you give me nice comments and say such wonderful things. Just thank you guys. Thank you for hitting subscribe, and thank you for giving me thumbs ups on these videos. If you appreciate it, man, the thumbs ups really helped me a lot. So, thank you guys, and that's my outdoor grow. That's my little outdoor grow right there. Got some Nia's Ultra Jack showing that off a little bit, but here I got some high time set up. I'm gonna sit down. I'm gonna enjoy my tuna melt with a root beer and some probably some Fritos with it. But again, thank you guys. Hit subscribe. Thank you for watching Cooking with Nay. Hope you enjoy your tuna melts, people. I know I'm gonna enjoy this one. Happy 420, legalized everywhere. Peace. Oh, damn, I forgot, guys. I was walking in the kitchen and I realized I didn't put my oregano on the top. I think that's very important to do. When you're done with the tuna melt, it adds a nice visual appearance to it. So here, I'll show you what I'm talking about. Take a little oregano like this and just sprinkle it on the top. This little oregano. And you know what that does? It gives it the visual charm. That oregano on there, and it smells wonderful, but it really does give it that restaurant, a little gourmet flair. So yeah, don't forget to put your oregano on your tuna melts. Once again, please hit subscribe, thumbs up. Thanks for watching. Happy 420, legalized everywhere.
Oh my goodness, peace. I just had to say this tuna melt's amazing. It's amazing. And I want to say why. It's exploding with all kinds of flavor. It's crunchy and chewy. You got, when you bite into the little vegetables, you get the moisture from the vegetables. And you get the dry, crunchy bagel. The cheesy on top and the tuna fish mixed with all that meat and stuff. I mean, all the vegetables and everything. And it's just amazing. I just wanted to say that. I'm really enjoying this tuna melt. Peace.